रजोजुषे जन्मनि सत्त्ववृत्तये स्थितौ प्रजानां प्रलये तमस्पृशे अजाय सर्गस्थिति नाशहेतवे त्रयीमयाय त्रिगुणात्मने नमः। लेट मी आई होप यू ऑल गॉट दिस बुक। आई जस्ट स्प्लिट एंड पुट दैट इनटू वन पीडीएफ। आई होप यू ऑल गॉट दैट। गुड। ओके, सो वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद एन इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट कादंबरी एंड लुक्ड एट अ कपल ऑफ सेंटेंसेस। सो तात चंद्रापीड विदित वेदितव्यस्य अधीत सकलशास्त्रस्य अधीत सर्वशास्त्रस्य तेन अल्पमपि उपदेष्टव्यमस्ति केवलञ्च निसर्गत एव अभानुभेद्यम् अरत्न आलोक छेद्यम् अप्रदीप प्रभापनेयम् अतिगहनम् तमो यौवन प्रभवम्। सो दिस इज द इंट्रोडक्शन दैट शुकनास इज गिविंग। सो ही कांट जस्ट स्टार्ट ऑफ ऑन डोंट डू दिस एंड डोंट डू दैट, राइट? So he has to say, you know, I don't need to advise anything for you. It's just that, you know, nisargata eva, naturally certain things associated with yavvanam will make you, pull you in a different direction. So it is going to cover you with andhakaram, tamaha. That is why I have to advise. Not only that, he is going to give a couple of, reasons why he has to do this. So he continues with that. If anyone can read, you can read the two sentences. Abhinavan Modya, that is the next name that I see here. Why don't you read?
Shamita, you call me?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Appa, pere thappa soltena?
Illa, right.
Challenge, everybody has to study, read, and then only you will get a பழக்கம் இருக்கும். அப்பதான்
ஓகே. அபரிணாம உபசமோ தாருணே லக்ஷ்மி மதஹ
கஷ்டம்
கஷ்டம் கஷ்டம் அனஞ்சனவர்த்தி சாத்தியம் அபரம் இல்ல சாத்தியம் அபரம் ஐஸ்வர்யம் ஐஸ்வர்ய ஐஸ்வர்யதி
திமிர அந்தத்வம்
திமிர அந்தத்வம்.
ஓகே, வீல் ஸ்டாப் வித் தட். சோ அபரிணாம உபசமஹ தாருணஹ லக்ஷ்மி மதஹ ஹி செட் யவ்வன பிரபவம். தி அர்லியர் சென்டென்ஸ் வாஸ் அபானுபேத்யம் தமஹ அதிகஹனம் தமஹ யவ்வன பிரபவம். சோ டூ திங்ஸ் தட் சந்திராபீடா இஸ் ஃபேசிங் ஹியர். ஒன் இஸ் ஹி இஸ் யங், ஹி இஸ் இன் ஹிஸ் யூத். தி அதர் திங் இஸ் ஹி ஹேஸ் there is a possibility that he might be intoxicated because of Lakshmi, the wealth here. Oh. Right? So Lakshmi Madaha, just normal youth is not enough. Now he's born in a very rich family, born with a silver spoon, as we say. Right? So Lakshmi Madaha, how is this intoxication that, or the delirium, you can say, that comes out of this richness, riches that you have. அபரிணாம உபசமஹ தாருணஹ மதஹ. சோ திஸ் மதஹ இட் செல்ஃப், தி வேர்ட் ஹேஸ் டூ மீனிங்ஸ் ஹியர். ஒன் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் தி அரகன்ஸ், தி அதர் திங் இஸ் இன்டாக்சிகேஷன். சோ வென் யூ ஹாவ் எனி இன்டாக்சிகேஷன் அவுட் ஆஃப் ஆல்கோஹால், ஆஃப்டர் அ ஃபியூ, யூ நோ, மேபி தி திங் த ஆஃப்டர் அ ஃபியூ இயர்ஸ் யூ வாண்ட் ஃபீல் லைக் டேக்கிங் இன் ஆல்கோஹால், or after a few hours you are going to come down, something of that sort. There will be a parinamam, parinama upashamah, because of some transformation either in your state or in your ears. When you go to vardhakyam, definitely you are not going to feel attracted by all of this wealth. But here this Lakshmi madaha is such that even in your vardhakya avastha, it is going to be terrible and it will attract you. It will create an intoxication for you. So Lakshmyaha madaha dhanasampattehe madaha aparinama upashamaha darunaha. It is dharunaha bhishanaha. It is bhayankaraha. And when you use madaka vastu like sura, etc., alcohols, those things have a limit that till which you get attracted. After some time, you're not going to get attracted towards it. Right? You may move on to something else there. So here, a parinama. Parinama is vardhakya avastha. Vardhakya avasthayam upashamaha yati madaha. Generally, you don't feel like taking on alcohol in your very old age. And whereas this Lakshmi Madaha is such that Ajivanam, until your end of life, you're going to feel that, let's say, Brahmaha, right? So, Parinama Upashamaha Yatrana Vidyate Tadrashaha Madaha. Aparinama Upashamaha Madaha. So, Pariname Vayav Parinatav. So, this Vyakhyanam is actually a very nice one. You can find Paryayavachi Shabda for these in a very nice manner he has given. And the last two sentences also, I think you can read. It gives out the whole thing in a very simple manner. Suradi madaka padartha upasevana utpanna unmattata. Suradi madaka vastu. Madaka vastu is that which intoxicates someone. That can at least change at some point where aushadhadina, either by giving an aushadham or kaladhike atite, or you can actually get over it at some point. You know, they no longer attract you after a certain point. That can also be there. During youth, you might feel like taking all these things, and then at a certain point, you might not feel like doing all these things. So none of those things exist for Lakshmi Madaha. Wealth is going to attract you no matter what. And there is no medicine for curing that. So Aparinama Upashamaha Darunaha Lakshmi Madaha. Now, this is also another thing, is this Aishwarya Timira Andhatvam. This wealth is like a Timira Andhatvam. Timira Andhaha is like a cataract. He uses a lot of metaphors, Rupakalankara here. This is all Rupakalankaram for you. So, Timira Andhatvam is a rogam which exists. This Aishwaryam is like, wealth is like a Timira Andhatvam. Cataract is something that can be removed. You have, there is another type of rogam of the eye, which is also, I don't know what this, it could be night blindness or something like that. So Ayurveda lists a lot of aushadham for that. In the mai kuchi irkalya, you know, the stick that you use to wear kajal, that stick is usually used with a medicine, and you wear it in your eye regularly, and that is supposed to clear off certain blindness, and that is there in Ayurveda Shastram. Yeah, I think it is there in Madhava Nidanam or something. I'm not sure. Ashtanga Hridayam also mentions, he has it here. Yes, Ashtanga Hridaye Ayurvediya Grante Rasendra Bhujagau Tulyau Tayoho Tulyam Atha Anjanam. That is what we need here. Anjanam is kajal. So a type of, not the usual kajal that we wear, but it is like the, with the aushadham, with the medicine. So ananjana varti sadhyam, anjana varti sadhyam timira andhatvam, parantu aishwaryam nama timira andhatvam, anjana varti sadhyam nasti. It cannot be resolved by applying any medicine. You cannot use an applicator and apply. Varti is a stick. So anjana varti sadhyam, it can be cured. What can be cured? Any sort of night blindness or the rogam of the eye, netra rogam can be cured with using an applicator. But here, aishwaryam nama timira andhatvam netra rogaha yaha vidyate, tattu anjana varti sadhyam nasti kashtam. So he says, what do I do about this? You know, when you, kashtam is alas or something. It's an expression of sadness that he cannot do anything about it. Okay, next slide.
Ashishiraha upachara haryaha. Okay, haryaha atitivraha darpa daha jwara ushma. Okay, jwara ushma.
Ashishira upachara haryaha atitivraha darpa daha jwara ushma. Now he spoke about Lakshmi Madaha. Next is Aishwaryam. What is the difference between the intoxication of Lakshmi? Next is just wealth in general produces a darkness or a buddhi. It just closes, gives you blindness almost. The next one is Darpaha. Darpaha is arrogance. arrogance is like a dahajwaram. Dahajwaram na extreme fever which constantly gives you a pipasa. It makes you thirsty constantly and it just burns from the inside. That is called dahajwaram. So this darpaha, arrogance is like a dahajwara ushma, the heat of fever, which is extreme, atitivraha. So when you have this fever in your body, immediately you can do some cold applicators. You can put ice or chandanam and all that to remove it. Right, the dahajwaram, to cure a dahajwaram, you can use shishira upacharaha. Upachara is, upacharamna or edha?
Applications.
Or... Applications, yeah.
Treatment.
Sarak chandana, treatment, yes. Treatment. So, sarak chandana adihi. Sarak chandana, sarak is mala and chandanam is sandalwood. So, you can use, apply many things to cool down the body. நம்ம இதுலலாம் உடம்பு சூடு கண்டுடுத்துன்னா விளக்கெண்ணெய் தடவி பாம்பா. யூனோ இது யூஸ் காஸ்டர் ஆயில் டு பிரிங் டவுன் த ஹீட் ஆஃப் த பாடி. ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் கூலிங் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட்ஸ் தட் யூ யூஸ். So that is. So,
madam, you mentioned mala also. Mala also is used as a coolant.
Yes, wow. If you have read Shakuntalam or any drama, someone who is going through viraha dahajwaram, viraha jwara, they use this mala. They wear bracelets using lotus stalks, and they lie down on lotus leaves. These are all the different shishira upachara that is done to reduce the heat in the body.
Oh, okay, like a heat radiator. Fantastic.
In Kadambari, actually later part, she would be sitting inside a building made of marble, which is supposed to be extremely cooling, and on a marble bed with a lot of the lotus leaves, which were constantly changed by the servants. That description itself will be beautiful. So that is called Shishira Upacharam, any sort of treatment to cool the body. Now this Dahajwaram can be removed, cured, even if it is Atitivram, you have some sort of a cure for it. You can at least have a Tylenol and get rid of it. That is also not possible here if it is arrogance. That arrogance is like a heat that is constantly burning in you, which cannot be removed at all.
So that arrogance is only because of the Lakshmi mother and not because of the youthness, right?
No, this one can be both. He just talks about arrogance. He doesn't say from where it comes from. Because he spoke of Aishwaryam, Lakshmi madaha and Yavvanam, I would say that arrogance during this time because of all of these things.
Okay.
In general, darpaha. Aham.
Because when youth goes away, then it should go away, right? But in this case, when the Lakshmi is there, it will always be there.
Yeah, because Lakshmi madaha ajivanam, jivana pariyantam asti. So this is also going to exist. And despite whether it is because of youth or because of Lakshmi, you can generally have an ahankara. Need not even a person who doesn't have 5 rupees in his hand can have an ahankara, can have an arrogance. Right? It may not be connected with those two also. So darpa dahajwara ushma. Ushma is ushnata. The heat that comes from the dahajwara, the fever, which is darpa ahankaraha, it cannot be removed. Shishira upachara haryaha pariharthum yogyaha nasti. Shishira upacharaihi, it cannot be removed. Next.
Satatam amula. Amula mantra gamyo gamyaha vishamo vishamaha vishaya
vishaya visha
vishaya visha
aswada mohaha
aswa vishaya visha aswada mohaha nit
no, the next one, that is another okay. One, so we'll just stop with this. Satatam amula mantra gamyaha vishamaha vishaya visha aswadaha. Vishayaha are the 5 objects, the sense organs, 5 sense organs, the objects that the sense organs experience is called the vishaya. That is vishayaha. Vishaya is not any subject matter or anything. So this is very specific. He compares the vishayaha to visham. In Viveka Chudamani, he says, doshena tibro vishayaha krishna sarpa vishadivate Visham nihanti bhoktaram drashtaram chakshushapi ayam. See, Visham, the poison will only kill a person who tastes it. Visham nihanti bhoktaram. Only the one who enjoys the visha is going to be killed. Whereas this vishaya vishaha is even more virulent than that. Chakshusha, drashtaram chakshusha api ayam. When you just merely look at it, it is going to kill you. Shabdadibhi panchabirapi pancha panchatva mapuhu kuranga matanga kuranga matanga patanga meena bhringa naraha panchabir anchitakkin. He says, for each one animal is going to be attracted by one sense organ. If you look at Kuranga, Kuranga is the deer. Deer just hears a sweet music and it gets trapped by the hunter. Kuranga Matanga. Matanga, an elephant, you take the hunter uses the female elephant to trap the male elephant because the elephant gets attracted by the sparsha of female elephant. So Kuranga Matanga, Patanga. The Vittalpoochi, then firefly. The firefly gets attracted to the light and it goes and falls into the fire and dies. So it gets destroyed only by Rupam. So Shabda, if you take each and every sense organ, these animals only get attracted by one. So Kuranga, Matanga, Patanga, Meena. Meena by taste. You put in a hook and it gets trapped because of the sense of taste. Bringa, the the honey bee gets attracted by smell. It gets attracted to the smell and then takes the madhu from the flower. And you can get trapped because of that. You can trap the honey or you can take the honey from there. Madhuha and the Avadhuta Gita. You should study the Avadhuta Gita where he explains how each and every person, every animal is a guru for the Avadhuta, for the Yati to lead his life. So this Vishayaha is like a poison, Vishaya Visha Aswada Madaha. Aswada Mohaha. It gives a Moha Brahmam. As you keep trying to enjoy the objects of the world, it does not get satisfied at all. The man gets pulled by all of these five organs. What to say of him, right? Naraha Panchavihi Ansitaha. If each one of those animals is getting attracted only by one sense organ, the man is getting attracted by five. He is being pulled in five different directions. So how can we remove that poison that is there in him? So Vishaya Visha Aswada Mohaha Ati Vishamaha Asti. It is extremely difficult because you cannot remove it. Any poison can be removed by Mani Mantra Aushadhi. You can have money is a gem. Any gem can remove certain bad effects. There is a great science of called gemology which thrives on that. There is Garuda mantram which you can use to remove the poison of a snake or aushadhi. Any medicine can be used. None of these is possible to remove that vishaya visham. The sense organs that are getting pulled, the objects that give you that aswada, that moham, that cannot be removed either by moolam or mantra. Moolam here is aushadhi, mantra is any incantation. So satatam, always, a moola mantra gamyaha vishamaha vishaya visha aswada mohaha. So the moha, the delusion that arises out of enjoying the different objects that are there in the world, it cannot be removed. Na gamyaha agamyaha. Kena moola mantrena moolaihi athava mantraihi na gamyaha. It cannot be removed. It is always present.
Amoola is there. So the a you shifted to gamyaha.
You have to connect it to, even in the samasa, you take the nanya and connect it with the verb.
Action. Oh, okay. Excellent.
So, moola mantraihi agamyaha. Iti amoola mantra gamyaha.
I was thinking moola mantra refers to Omkara or something.
Possible. You can say that too. Let me check what he says here. Moolaihi is aushadha moolaihi.
Ayurveda probably. Moolam.
Moolam. Yeah.
Moolam, yeah.
Aushadhi and mantram. Mani cannot be used for visham, I think. That's why he just uses moola and mantra.
Yeah, yeah, mani is only for, I think, alaukika things.
Right. True.
Effects of planets, etc. You can nullify with that.
You can use gems for that. Correct. Okay, next one.
Yes. Mahode, aparinama upashama tatra api parinama anupashama iti bhavati va
parinamena upashamaha na niyate iti athava na vidyate iti ananjana varti sadhyam ityatra api anjana vartina yate na sadhyam bhavati tat ashishira upachara haryah shishira upacharaihi parihartum na yogyah iti ashishira upachara haryah
astu mahode dhanyavad.
Next.
Nityam asnana shaucha shaucha badhyah balavan raga mala raga mala raga
mala avalepaha. Raga mala avalepaha. Malam is any dirt that is present on the body. Avalepaha is pooch. How do I say?
Smearing.
Smearing. Yes, smearing. Mala avalepaha, the smearing of any dirt, that is ragam here. So it is like, you know, you have some dirt on your body, you can immediately either do snanam or shaucham. If it is antarmalam, then you can try to use shaucham to remove that also. But this ragam is a type of mala avalepaha. Avalepaha actually has two meanings. Avalepaha also means garvaha, ahankaraha. So it is like a ahankaram. This ragam is mostly, he only uses the meaning of smearing here. He doesn't use the word ahankara here. This is not ahankara. So just take it as avalepaha, mala avalepaha. Malasya avalepaha, ragaha eva malaha. Tasya avalepaha. So this raga attachment is like a dirt which is constantly present in our body. And now how do we remove that? If it is normal dirt, we can remove it by snanam. Snana badhyaha. Snana badhyaha is nashaniyaha. It can be removed by snanam or shaucham, shuchikriya. Sometimes you have performed an action, you have also taken a bath, but still you do some purificatory actions, right? Samskaraha. Those are also some purificatory actions that you have to do. The child is born, you clean up the child, but still you do jatakarma. That is a ritualistic purification. So there are two types. One is just an outward, the other is ritualistic. So snana and shaucha. That's why he has given two types of purificatory action.
Actually, earlier also there was one external and one internal. The moola was internal, the body treatment, and the extra in mental mantra treatment was mantra. Fantastic.
Correct point. I didn't recognize that. That's a nice point. So snana and shaucha. One is external and internal. Asnana shaucha badhyaha. So snanena shauchena va na badhyaha iti asnana shaucha badhyaha. It cannot be removed either by snanam or by shaucham, which is rituals. Tadrisha ragaha. Balavan raga mala avalepaha. It is so strong that it is constantly sticking to us that it cannot be removed either by outward purification or inward purification. Next one. Now you get the trend of his the way he arranges his samasa, right? So it'll be faster. Then he will change his trend again.
Next. Ajasram aksha
akshapa
akshapa avasana avasana prabodha ghora cha rajya sukha sannipata nidra bhavati iti Vistarena abhidhiyase.
He's still saying. Now see, he's listed, right? No, he's listed, okay, right? So the madaha, yavvana madaha, yavvana prabhavam, lakshmi madaha, ragam. And then now the last one is rajya sukham. Rajya Sukham is like a nidra. It is like a sleep, ghora nidra. It's a very terrible nidra from which you cannot wake up at all. Someone will not even want to, enjoy the sukham that is there in this rajyam. Rajya Sukha Sannipata Nidra Ghora Akshapa Avasana Prabodha. Kshapa Avasane Api Aprabodha. Kshapa is night, Nisha. Nishayaha Avasane Ante. Even at the end of night, you cannot wake up from this sleep. Such a sleep is this Rajya Sukham. Rajya Sukha Sannipataha or Sanghataha. Sannipata. Wait, let me check another text. I think it says Sanghatena here. Sannipata Nidra is this. Pramila. Sannipataha is Sanghataha Eva Nidra.
Some kind of a trance sleep?
Maybe. Yeah, I think we can take it like that. Sanghata is Kshapa Avasane. There is just Kshapa Avasana Prabodha. Sannipata Ngarthi. Anubhavaha. He just says Adhipatya Sukha Anubhavaha Eva Nidra. Sushuptihi. Okay.
Deep sleep.
Deep sleep. This is like a deep sleep. So Sannipata is Sushupti. Rajya Sukha, Sannipata Nidra, deep sleep like Sushupti. This is very ghora, it is very troublesome, or it is so bhishanam, bhayankaram, the terrible, that Ajasram. Ajasram is you can never wake up. Ajasram always. Always you cannot wake up. There is no prabodha. There is no waking up from such a sleep, deep sleep. Iti vistarena abhidiyase. That is why you are being advised in detail here. It runs to 40 pages here, right? So, iti vistarena abhidiyase. So, all the things that he mentioned are something to be aware of. So we will think that this is all, right? So he is going to list another 4 aspects in particular that is present in Chandrapeta, which may not be present in everybody else. The other things are like we may have yavvanam, or we may have money, we may have an ahankara or attachment or Rajya Sukham, something or the other might be present. But all of these qualities are going to be present in Chandrapeda, not Ragam or Darpam, but he is just going to show the 4 qualities that are present in Chandrapeda, which is like an anartha parampara that is going to pull him, that might pull him. So he is warning him. Shukanasa is warning Chandrapeda now.
Pratamam, garbha ishwaratvam, abhinava yavanatvam, dvitiyam, tritiyam, apratima arupatvam.
Apratima rupatvam.
Pratima Rupatvam. Chaturtham Amanusha Shakti
Shaktitvam.
Shaktitvam. Ancheti Mahatiyam Kalvanartha Parampara Sarva.
So Garbheshwaratvam, Abhinava Yavvanatvam, Apratima Rupatvam, Amanusha Shaktitvam Cha Iti Mahati Iyam Khalu Anartha Parampara Sarva. This is one parampara, shrinkhala. This is like a list. He is saying that all of these 4 things are present in you. If even one of this, he will actually, then if we should read with the next sentence. Avinayanam, can you also read the...
Avinayanam,
ekaikam,
apyesham, api,
esham,
so api yesham ayatanam kimuta samavayaha kim uta samavayaha
kimuta samavayaha ekaikamapi yesham ayatanam avinayanam ekaikamapi yesham ayatanam. So it means each one of these are avinayanam ayatanam. It is the repository for pushing you into avinaya karya. Vinaya is disciplined, not humble. इट इज डिसिप्लिन्ड अविनय इत्युक्ते इनडिसिप्लिन्ड शास्त्रोक्त रीत्या आई मीन यू हैव टू डू वर्क दैट इज विनयम विनयपूर्व कार्यम इज द वर्क दैट इज डन बिकॉज ऑफ फॉलोइंग द शास्त्र मार्ग इफ यू डू नॉट फॉलो द शास्त्र मार्गम इट इज एन अविनय कार्यम अविनयानाम आयतनम दिस इज ईच वन ऑफ दिस लिस्टेड इन फ्रंट इज it is an instigator for making you do something which is an indisciplined action. Kimuta samavayaha, what to say if all four are present? Now let's see what those things are. Garbheshwaratvam, garbhate ishwaratvam, natu ajanma, not after birth. Here, from the time that he was in the womb, he has had this ishwaratvam. The significance of this will be understood only if we have read the earlier part where I told you Tarapida and Vilasavati did not have a child for a long time. They had done all sorts of puja, rituals and everything, shastra prakaram or yagam, yajnam, everything. And then she got him. So when she was pregnant also, she was surrounded with so many auspicious things. The entire description of that will also be nice. So Garbha Ishwaratvam, he had a control over everybody right from the time that he was in the womb. So Garbheshwaratvam. Now Abhinava Yavvanatvam, he has just entered into Yavvanam. Abhinavam is new, Nutanam. Nutanataya Yavvane Pravishtaha. So Abhinava Yavvanatvam, Apratima Rupatvam. He has a very handsome physique. So he cannot be compared at all. He's so wonderful, handsome to look at. Amanusha Shaktitvam. There is a description of his Vyayama, the exercises that he does. So that will give you a clue to this. No? This Amanusha Shaktitvam. Everything has its clue in the earlier sections. That's why, you know, it makes more sense to read completely. We are, of course, taking out only a portion of it and studying. That's okay. So Amanusha Shaktitvam. He has a Shakti which is beyond human. It's something that you cannot imagine. Each one of these, Mahati Khalu Anartha Parampara Iyam. Iyam Parampara, this list, this Shrinkala is Anartha Parampara. It results in a bad thing. Anartham is Kettadalatha Mudiyum. Right? It will result in it'll make you do everything indisciplined and then cholitare. So he said, Avinayanam Ayatanam. So it is going to end very badly. But each one of these is an Ayatanam for Avinayam. What to say of a Samavayaha? Samavayaha is, see, in Nyaya.
Same plane.
Samavaya, there is a difference between Samyoga and Samavaya in Nyaya. Yeah? Samyoga is something that you can separate. Samavaya is something that you cannot separate.
Nitya
so all four are present in him. In a samavaya.
Inseparable property.
Inseparable properties that are present in him, right? So Kimuta Samavaya. All four of them are present in him.
Tatra abhidhiyase iti asti kila. I mean, can you explain that part again? I didn't understand, you know, how that's actually.
Abhidhiyase. Tvam abhidhiyase maya. So it is a kartari prayoga, karmani prayoga.
Okay.
Aham abhidhatteya mama. Aham abhidhat. No, I can't get it quickly like that.
But anyway, it's madhyama purusha ekavachana.
Madhyama purusha ekavachanam, but in karmani prayoga. So tvam maya shukanasena abhidhiyase. Okay.
यौवन आरंभे च प्रायः शास्त्र जल प्रक्षालन निर्मल अपि
कालुष्यम
उपयाति बुद्धिः.
No, he says you have all four. Now when यौवन आरंभे, now he has to attack the यौवन प्रभावम. Now that is he starts off with that. So the introduction is over. Now he starts off with how this Yavvanam is going to change your attitude. no, until that point, until the children are like 12 years, you know, or 13 years, even 13 is okay, I should say. When they enter into that 15, 16, something happens to their brain. That's what he says very beautifully here. Shastra jala prakshalana nirmala api buddhihi kalushyam upayati prayaha. It doesn't say your buddhi. Chandrapeda's buddhi has turned, he doesn't say, but he says prayaha, generally, yavvana arambhe, in the beginning of yavvanam, shastra jala prakshalana nirmala api buddhihi, even though the buddhi has been rendered pure, nirmala, because of, you know, washing it with shastra jala. Shastra jala prakshalanena nirmala api buddhihi, suddenly something just attacks it, no? Kalushyam upayati. The kalushasya bhavaha kalushyam. Dirty, kalakkamambo. Some agitation comes inside that brain. No? It's like dirtying the water. Adhudan kalushata.
Pollution.
Pollution, na? Sorry. I think you can say pollution. Some words are so, Tamil is so too, very close to my heart there. And the kalakkamangarada vandu, I am not able to translate it.
Mixing it in Abhati. So.
Mixing, yeah, probably.
Turbulence.
Appa, buying thesaurus tha adu. Yeah, you can say turbulence. So, buddhihi, nirmala api buddhihi, kalushyam upayati. It gets agitated or it gets dirtied there. So, at the beginning of yavvanam. Okay.
Anujita
dhavalata api.
Dhavalata api. Sarak eva bhavati. Yunam drishtihi.
Yunam drishtihi. Yunam yuvakanam tarunanam drishtihi. Their eyesight. Saraga eva bhavati. This is a Virodhabhasa alankara. So this Virodhabhasa alankaram is something a little bit difficult to understand. So you can't connect all of those words. I'm giving you the disclaimer before itself. It is very difficult to connect all the words in the final meaning. So let's go one by one. Anujjita dhavalata api saraga iva drishtihi. Drishtihi saraga iva asti. First is the visheshanam for drishti, yunam drishtihi, is anujjita dhavalata. It has not let go of its whiteness. Dhavalata yasmat na ujjita. Ujjhitana, there is whiteness still in the sight, eyesight of youth. At the same time, saraga, it also has a redness. Now, an eye which has both white and red cannot exist. So there is a virodham. There is a contradiction there. So virodha pariharartham, you take a second meaning for one of the words and say saraga iti. Ragena saha, with attachment. So it does not let go of its whiteness, but that part will not come in the parihara. So you just say, saraga iva yunam drishtihi vartate. The youth, the drishti or the eyesight of young people is always with an attachment. They look at anything, they want it, they covet it. Something or the other, immediately they want it. So that is yunam drishtihi. Yunam drishtihi. Anujjita dhavalata api, even though it has not let go of its whiteness, it still has ragam.
In the sense there is hope. The dhavalata is there, except the raga has to be taken out.
Yeah.
Or does it mean that although the eye looks white, anujjita dhavala, there is color in it.
So there is just, still there is ragam, that raktima is, you cannot immediately take that meaning, but ultimately you only take it as attachment. If you take the meaning of raktima, then it is virodham. It is a contradiction. Then, so anujjita dhavalata api saraga eva bhavati yunam drishtihi. It is as if it has an attachment. So here drishtihi sakshat raga yukta bhavitum na arhati. It cannot have an attachment, right? The drishti cannot have an attachment. It is only the manas which has the attachment through the drishti. So, saraga iva again becomes utpreksha here. It is Utreksha is a poetic fancy.
The mental coloring has been associated with whether his eyes could be seen red. No, they don't seem to be red, but mentally it seems to be red.
Mentally it is attached. Yeah, it seems to be as if it has an attachment, right?
So the raga here is attachment or red?
It is both. First you take it as red, but that redness, you have to let go of that meaning and take it as attachment.
Okay.
That is the point of Virodhabhasa.
Okay.
This is one alankaram which Bana uses everywhere in his descriptions. He will list out some 4 or 5 Virodhabhasa alankaras in some descriptions. In the Balarka Dyutihi Api, Bala, something like that. You know, even though she is looking like the sun, she still has the darkness of the moon or the night, which is her hair. So her face is like a Surya Kanti, but her hair has that Andhakara Yuktam. So how can both exist at the same time? So you're actually describing her, but the Virodham also exists there in the use of Slesha words, Slishta words. So you need Slesha, but you don't call it a Slesha Alankara. You just use Slishta Padam to explain Virodhabhasa.
Okay.
Okay.
Not quite like an oxymoron, Ilya.
No.
No.
No, oxymoron actually has no explanation, right?
Hmm. So Dhavalata means pure white, but then it also means if you say Saraga is attachment, then Dhavalata should be unattached, pure.
No, it is not pure. That is the whole point.
What she's saying is
a simple thing, as Ashwiniji said, you know, it is just the whiteness that is present in an eye. You know, the white part that is there in the eye. That's all it means. It's a very plain and simple meaning. That's all.
Okay. Okay.
But Saraga is where you have two meanings, and that is where the contradiction arises, and you say it has attachment. Where Yuvakanam Drishtihi to Sarvatra Saraga Yukta Eva Vartate. It gets
double application.
Yeah.
It's a double application of the same word, right? So,
Aparityaktana, what does it mean?
So, Dhavalata Yatra na Parityakta na Ujjita. It's the same way as we had done Ananjana Vartitvam, Amula Mantra Gamyaha. Where you take the nanya and use it with the kriyapadam, right? So it does not still let go of its whiteness. It is still white. Yet there is ragam in it. What is that ragam? Ragam is attachment. It is not redness.
One other question about Utpreksha Alankara. Yada virodhabhasam svikrumaha chet utpreksha na bhavitum arhati kalu. You cannot add both, because as soon as you take raga as the color, then it's no longer...
Atra utpreksha katham vartate ityukte saraga iva iti, I am looking at it from a philosophical point and saying drishte hetu tatra chetanatvam nasti. Manasaha drishti samyukte eva padarthe ragaha bhavitum arhati. So if the manas, the attachment is not in the drishti per se, right? It is only in the manas. So I looked at it as utpreksha and said, so saraga eva drishtihi ityukte manasaha eva tatra ragaha vartate natu drishtehe. Does it make sense? No, if it doesn't, then please erase the utpreksha out of your mind. Let's just have it as Virodhabhasa. Not convincing.
So the Anujjita Dhavalata there, does it talk about the innocence actually in the eyes?
No.
Nothing with that?
No. Don't go into that. Anujjita Dhavalata is
Shastra Jala Prakshalita Akshi.
So the eyes are white and clear. Okay. And Ujjita, like you used the Dhatu Ujj in describing Gadyam as well. You said it is Anujjita, not bound by meter. You used in the first class, right? Anujitam, I think Gadyam, not bound by meter.
So not it's the same bound by meter is, yeah. Ujjitam is Tyaktam.
Atyaktam.
Anujjitam is aparityaktam.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So even in Canada, we use the word ujjo. Ujjodu means to rub and remove. In Canada, we use the word ujjo.
So it's in, ujj means to abandon. The dhatu is there.
I have not connected. That is very interesting, Ashwini Bagini.
That's nice. Okay. So, do the next one more. Yeah. Just one more line.
I think he has some. I just had a comment. So
yeah.
The other comment was the dhatu kal. Kala means to confusion. The dhatu kal means to make
for
sounds.
Kalushyam.
So kala is confusion. So kali, confusion, kali yuga.
Kali also is kamadhenu. So kali kamadhenu. You can take any meaning for that depending on the context.
So kalushyam, confusion.
Confusion.
Apaharati cha vateva shushkapatram samudbhuta rajo bhranti rati duramatma iccheya yavana samaye purusham prakritihi.
Okay. Apaharati cha vatya iva shushkapatram samudbhuta rajo bhrantihi atiduram atmechaya yavana samaye purusham prakritihi. So purusham prakritihi atma iccheya atiduram apaharati. Purusham prakritihi, prakriti is nature. Yavvana samaye, during the yavvanam, during youth, purusham atma iccheya, according to its own wish. It just takes a person apaharati, it takes him atiduram. It just takes him away from the normal path that he has to take. Katham vatya eva, just like a whirlwind, you know, like a hurricane. Vatya is like a hurricane. So hurricane, just as how a hurricane lifts a shushka patram and takes it away from where it should be, it takes it atiduram. Shushka patram atiduram yatha nayati apaharati vatya tatha purusham prakritihi api nayati. The nature, yavvana samaye, you know, prakriti is more like ajnanam here, which is ajnanasya prabhavaha atitivraha asti yavvana samaye. It is extreme during yavvanam that it just takes a person away from the intended path. If this is the path that he has to go in, it just moves it according to its own wish. So prakriti acts on its own here. How does it do it? Samudbhuta rajo bhrantihi. It creates a bhranti out of rajoguna, samudbhuta. Rajasa bhrantihi udbhutam. Bhrantihi is atasmin tadbuddhihi. You know, you say atasmin, rajau sarpa buddhihi is bhrantihi. On a rope, if you think it is serpent, or in a kilinjal. Oyster shell, you look at it and think it is rajatam. You think it is
shuktau rajatam.
Shuktau rajatam. That is also called atasminna tadbuddhihi. Tasminna tadbuddhihi iti paramarthikam. That is reality. If you have the concept, if you have the perception of rajatam in rajatam, then there is no issue. Atasminna yatra rajatam na vidyate. Where there is no silver, you perceive silver there, then that is bhrantihi. Atasmin tadbuddhihi. Here, rajaha eva, rajasa ya bhrantihi utpadyate. Rajogunena. It is only that activity that creates that confusion. If you are sattvaguna pradhanam and you are quiet, you are calm, you understand what is true and what is not. What is nityam and anityam. Whether it is intellectual, you may not be aware of it. Even an intellectual perception will be possible only if there is sattva pradhanam in you. Tamav pradhanam, you are not aware at all. But rajas gives you that activity and creates confusion. You may be unaware of something, that is fine. But for you to be confused about something, you need to have that rajasaha adhikyam. So rajasa bhrantihi utpadyate samudbhuta rajo bhrantihi. Because prakriti creates that confusion in you and she takes you away in her own, according to her own wishes. Right?
Atmecheya is the Purusha's own Ichcha is defeated by the Prakriti, that sense.
Purusha's Ichcha is defeated by Prakriti's Ichcha. Atma Ichcheya here is more like Prakriti's Ichcha. Okay. So Shushka Patram Iva, Vatya Iva. Now, what does this Vatya do, this hurricane? That also creates a confusion with Rajaha. Rajaha is dust. So Samudbhuta Rajavabhrantihi. It creates a dust, confusion with dust, and then removes the Shushka Patram, dry leaves, because it is easier to remove the dry leaves and take it away. So it also connects to the Upamanam and the Upameya. Right, so Vatya Iva Prakritihi, Samudbhuta Rajobhrantihi, Shushka Patram Iva Purusham, Yavvana Samaye Atiduram Atma Ichchaya Apaharati. So we are not...
I didn't know about Raja being dust also. That is very, very useful. Yeah.
So in other words, during Yavvanam, everybody has gone through that. So we understand perfectly how this is, how this works, right?
So, yeah, and actually, it is so beautiful. Purusha is in Pullinga and Prakriti in Strilinga and helps the Kavi nicely.
Right? I think it comes in Vishnu Suktam. Rajaha Parthivani Yaha Vimame. The one who counted every particle of the universe, Rajaha. It comes in the first line. Right, Padmanabhanvarya, you remember it? That line?
I think so, yeah.
Vishnu Nukam Parthivani.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay.
Oh. Right?
Yeah, sorry about that.
Okay. When the Rajo, so Vishnu counts every particle Raja in the universe, so the same Raja, single particle.
Rajo guna pradhan, Rajas vandu Vishnu ka na, sattu guna pradhanam la.
No. I mean, in that he has counted every particle in the universe. In that he's in every particle in the universe. Rajas particle, Raja particle.
Rajas is also particle. So here particle, it is dust. That is the meaning here. Dust.
Yeah.
Rajas is actually it is of the form of Trasareno. That is, you have four Trenukam together, Chaturanakam. That is that can only be visible to the eye, only when it is in the Rajas form, the dust. Yeah.
What is the four? What?
That is two.
Trenukam actually. It comes from Trenukam, right?
Trenukam. Correct. Trenukam. It is Trenukam. Yes. So when two Paramanu join, it is one Dhyanukam. And when three Dvyanukams join, it is one Triyanukam. And that Triyanukam is called Thrasarenu or Rajaha. That dust particle, you know, when sunlight comes through the window, you see certain particles which you won't see otherwise. If you close the curtain, you won't see those particles. But when you open the curtain and the sunlight falls through, you will see certain particles. That is called Thrasarenu, which is Triyanukam.
Is this the Kannada's...
I don't know. This is there in some...
Vaisheshika?
No, this is there in Tarkasanga.
It's in Nyaya. I don't know about Vaisheshika. Definitely in Nyaya.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Yeah.
So here, Rajas, Rajoguna here in this case, Rajobhranti is Rajas, right? Not the Kana, not the Raja, that Raja.
So there are two things. No? One is Vatya. When it applies to hurricane, it becomes Rajas, the particle. When it applies to Prakritihi, it is Rajoguna. That's why you take two meanings there. So it helps the Upama.
So in the Prakriti side, when you say Samudbhuta Rajobhranti, is the Bhranti Bhuta from the Rajas?
Yes.
Like is it born? Udbhuta. Yes. It's Udbhavati. From the Rajas.
Rajasaha Bhrantihi Rajobhrantihi or Rajasa Bhrantihi Samudbhuta Rajasa Bhrantihi. So because of Rajas, a Bhranti is created.
Born. Okay.
Born.
Today even we know this as the Rasa of the hormones.
What? No, I didn't get it.
It is actually these are hormonal impacts of Prakriti and Purusha.
Yavana Samaya, he's saying Yavana Samaya.
Yes, yes.
Right?
So the Vatya also is compared to the, it's Rajotama Vritti Kalu, because it's activity, it's frenzied, it's a hurricane.
Yes.
And Rajoguna is like, it's full of activity.
Yes. That's why he compares it to Vatya. Adadu, you know, like when a hurricane just takes away everything. That is how it is. It's not like a wind which just blows and it may shake a leaf or not. That is not the case here. It's not Vataha, but Vatya. Vatya is like a hurricane.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Shuravali.
Okay.
I mean, in that sense, when you say Shuravali, it's actually a tornado.
Ah, okay.
Twisting. You're talking about then, the twisting one, right? The one which twists and goes up.
That's
right?
Even worse, tornado. Right?
Yeah.
So that twists and takes everything and puts it in some other place. Oh, that is the meaning there. Ati duram apaharati. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's tornado. Okay.
So beautiful.
Stop with this.
Yep. Then
you left us hanging in the air.
Shushka patram eva.
Shushka patram eva.
Nice.
Dhanyavadaha. Guru.
Bahu dhanyavadaha.
Kopi mangalam kurvantu.
Om sahana vavatu sahanau bhunaktu sahaviryankara vavahai tejasvinavadhitamastuma vidvishavahai. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Okay.
Adbhutam. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Sarvebhyah.
Dhanyavada.